not been for the Lord. Real quick, I just want everybody to look at the person next to you and just say, the pain is propelling me to my purpose. The pain is propelling me to my purpose. See, if it had not been for the Lord, we would not understand that it takes pain to propel us to our purpose. See, in the year of 2020, many of us have suffered some pain. In the year of 2020, many of us have suffered some discomfort. In the year of 2020, some of us have reached our lowest point. In the year of 2020, some of us have lost loved ones. In the year of 2020, some of us have lost our jobs. In the year 2020, some of us have lost our financial security. In the year of 2020, some of us may have lost our minds, but it's the pain that's going to propel us to our purpose. See, when you think about the word pain, it means either physically or naturally or mentally, something is not right. Something is discomfort. Something is agitating. Something is uncomfortable. Pain can range from agitating pain, which is just a little small pain, a nagging pain. Usually you can take some Tylenol. Usually you can just lay down for a minute, it'll be gone. But then there's the debilitating pain. There's the pain that's gonna shake you to your core. There's the pain that's gonna make you feel like you out the game. It's the pain that's gonna make you feel like you can't move. It's the pain that make you call his name in the midnight hour. It's the pain that make you have to call on him in the midnight hour. It's the pain when you can't do nothing but say his name. Sometimes you can't say his name, you just gotta moan. Sometimes you just gotta Sometimes you just gotta Sometimes you just gotta grunt because you can't bear it. That's the kind of pain that some of us had to deal with in 2020. See, I can tell you about some pain in 2020. I started off the year of 2020 and my mind wasn't right. And I'm not talking about a mental illness. I'm talking about I wasn't right in my mind. Then after that, I started to lose hours on my job in 2020. In the midst of the pandemic, they took hours from me. But if it had not been for the Lord who was on my side, every rent was still paid. Every month was still made. Every bill was still paid. Then can I tell you a little more? Right a couple weeks before my birthday, my daddy was snatched from me in 2020. So I know about some pain. I know about some heartache. I know about some late night tears. I know about some things that we don't understand. But it's the pain that's gotta propel you to your purpose. See, when you think about being propelled, it means that it's a strong force that's got to come and it's got to push you. But sometimes we don't recognize when it's time to move. Sometimes we don't recognize when it's time to go to the next level. So sometimes the Lord will allow some afflictions to come. Sometimes he will allow the afflictions to come just to show you where you are, just to show you that it's time to move. And now that it's time to move, when we go into this next year, I don't want to hear about no more burdens of 2020. I don't want to hear about no pandemic. I don't want to hear about the turmoil. I don't want to understand death anymore. But even if we do have to suffer some more, God is saying it's for your purpose. Everything that you've been through, what you gonna do about it? What you gonna do with it? Every lesson that you had to learn, everything that it taught you, take it into the new year and birth your purpose. The Bible says in John 16 and 21, when a woman is in travail, she has sorrow because her hour has come. That means that when she's in birth, giving birth to her child, at that moment she feels the contractions. At that moment she feels the pain. But then the doctor walks in the room and he says, it's time to push. It's time to push because now you got to birth your purpose. All the pain you went through, all the late night hours you went through, everything you didn't understand, it's time to push. It's time to be propelled into your purpose. Mother Jackson said, this pandemic wasn't for the world. This was a wake-up call right here at home. He's saying, I need my people to be right, because when you walk into this next chapter, I need you to push. Be propelled into your purpose.